Hey everybody, and welcome back to another lecture with Coding with Roby. And in this video of the Python Bootcamp, we are going to learn about variables. Variables are containers for holding data values. There are some rules that apply when creating these containers, which we will cover. Let's start by saying print 10. If we save our file and then we right-click and click Run Variables, which is going to match the variable file name, we get the value of 10. However, 10 is just a number. It doesn't really contain anything other than the number 10, and there's no kind of reference to the 10. Right above print, let's say cost equals 10. Cost is a variable name which is now going to hold the value of 10. If we hover over cost, we can even see that it says variables. Cost, which is of type int, which is an integer, is equal to 10. We can now type in cost inside our print statement, and if we right-click and rerun the file, we'll see that nothing changes and the value stays at 10. Now, a good use case for variables is for us to be able to name specific data for certain activities. For example, let's say we wanted to print the cost of an item. Well, the cost of the item is $10. And to be able to find the cost, we now need to calculate the tax. So 10 plus, and then within parentheses, we need to say the cost again, which is 10, times the tax value of 0.25. And if we save this file and right-click Run Variables, we can see we now get the value of 12.5. And that's because the cost is 10, plus the cost times the percent of tax, which is going to equal 12.5. Now, to make this easier to understand, we can say cost is equal to 10. We can say tax percent is equal to 0.25. And then we can say tax is equal to cost times tax percent. And then finally, price is just the cost plus the tax. If we now eliminate this entire calculation and just type in price, and we save and rerun the file, we also get 12.5. Now, in this small example, we can see that 10 is cost, which is an integer. Tax percent is 0.25, which is considered a floating point number. And a floating point number is something that's going to be using decimals. An integer cannot use decimals. But there is something else. There's something called a string. So let's jump down and right under price, let's call a new variable username, which is equal to coding with Roby. And then I'm going to say another variable of first name equals Eric. Now, one thing you may notice is that coding with Roby and Eric both have double quotation marks surrounding the actual string that's going to be saved to the variable. Now, strings in Python can use either single quotes or double quotes, but for most of the tutorials, I'm going to be using double quotes. We can now print our username. And if we save our file and rerun the application, we'll get coding with Roby. And again, we'll get it right under 12.5 because we still have this code running. If we change username to first name, and we save and rerun the file, we'll now get Eric instead of coding with Roby. And now inside here, I'm now going to say username plus an empty string of one space plus first name. If we right click and run variables, we're going to see we get coding with Roby space Eric. And the reason I added this space was if we remove this and we rerun the application, it's all going to be one word. So I added the space just so we can separate the two words easily. Now we can also reassign variables to make new data points within that variable. So let's say we have our first num, which is equal to 10. We have a second number, which is equal to 2. If we print our first number and then print our second number, we should get 10 and 2 as a response. Let's save the file and rerun the application. We can see that we now get 10 and 2. However, right under this, I'm going to reassign first num to the number 1. And now I'm going to reprint first num and second num. If we right-click and rerun this application, we'll now get first num and second num, which is 10 and 2. And then we reassigned first num to 1, and then reprinted 1 and 2. So second num will always stay with the value of 2, while first num will change from the value of 10 to the value of 1. Now we can do the exact same thing with strings. So if we want to create the variable first name again, so I'm going to make equal to Eric, and we want to print first name. And then reassign first name to Melissa. And then reprint first name. We'll see that the value of Eric changes to Melissa. And there you have it. This covers the tutorial on variables. And I will see you in the next video.